Effect Compressor generally offers a much faster action than other compression technologies, and are well known for adding lush character to audio. Effect compressors usually have a fixed threshold, with the compression level being adjusted by using the input gain. Pulsar Audio have just released a modern take on the legendary 1178 compressor and kindly sent me a copy to check out. This incredibly versatile FET compressor is based on the vintage Stereo 1178, which can be found in studios all around the world, and it seriously packs some punch. Pulsar Audio's 1178 integrates the famous All Buttons In mode, and some of the shortest attack and release times you can find. Let's check it out. Pulsar Audio's 1178 is a really smart looking resizable interface. The vintage and modern mix-up that's inspired by the original 1178 hardware really looks stylish and everything's clear and really easy to understand. It's capable of stereo and mid-side compression and has plenty of modern twists on the original. This is going to be a really powerful tool to add to your virtual studio. Now when you first use the 1178, I would highly recommend selecting a starting point from the preset menu up here. I'll pick the drum one and try it out on this simple drum loop I've got. Now you'll notice that there's a suggestion here for the input gain. So let's use that as a starting point. And one little touch I really like here is how the input and output gains, they can link together when you hold down the shift key. And again, remember that this style of compressor does not have a threshold knob, so use the input to control the amount of compression. And this part, as well as many of the other parameters, they can be locked in place if you want to, let's say, keep the input and output gains the same, but you want to flick through the presets. And then looking at the ratio control here, which is the amount of compression that is applied to a signal exceeding the threshold, can be selected. And this includes the infamous All Buttons In mode that was characterized by its high ratio, heavy saturated sound, with a change in its attack and release behavior. And then moving on to the attack, the speed of the compression. So for example, use a fast attack to catch a percussive element, or if you want to let that element come through, then use a longer attack. Well, it's important to notice here that unlike a lot of the compressors out there and a lot of devices you use, the position here at zero is the longest attack time, not the shortest. So on the left you've got a long attack time of about 800 microseconds, and this increases, you know, gets sped up as you increase the value to 7, with that being the shortest attack time of about 20 microseconds. And then the speed at which the compressor stops reducing the gain once the input has fallen below the threshold is controlled with the release here. The positions on the release are similar to the attack, with the longest time of about 1.1 seconds on the left, speeding up to a fast release of 50 milliseconds on the right. With a low release time, the more audible the pumping effect will be. Now one of my favourite parts of the 1178 is the saturation, which can be switched between 4 different types. And I really love how you can twist this small screw here to calibrate the saturation. From slight coloration to very audible and destructive saturation. This is a really fun way of including a great feature. And let's look at the 4 types. So we've got the tape, which emulates obviously a cassette style magnetic recording technology. Warm, offering more of a subtle distortion, one that's great for high frequencies. triode emulates a Class A tube amp, adding mostly odd harmonics. And then finally clip mode, offering a more modern digital sound, you know, for heavy-handed action. With Pulsar Audio's 1178, there's plenty more common features you would expect. You've got your mix controls, A, B, and you know, plenty of other features. And there's also some really powerful controls if you're comfortable using compressors. I really like using the mid-side mode found here. I use this a lot in my productions that have a heavy synth or bass sound, you know, like electro house genres. And up until now, you may have noticed that the pots are all linked. And this can be changed here. So now I can independently control the left and right channels. And with a flick of the switch here, I can change this to the mid-side mode that I really like using. And I highly recommend you get comfortable using mid-side techniques in your productions. It really helps you clean up your sounds and make better mixes with great stereo dynamics. Now the sidechain EQ can be looked at as a way of shaping your compression even further. And there's a lot of control here, so I'll just give you a quick demonstration. Basically, by changing the curve on here, you can change how that bit of frequency, how that band is affected by the compressor. So to demonstrate, if I focus in on the element, like let's say the snare here, you can hear a lot more clearly what's going on. I can also solo this as well, and do lots of other things. The controls in this section are very comprehensive, containing many of the features you'd expect, including external detection source if your door supports it, many other things like a powerful look ahead, look behind slider. This will help you catch transients even quicker than the fast attack times allow. And there's many more things you can do with this, making Pulsar Audio's 1178 an extremely useful tool to have, one of the most versatile compressors you will own. Now I know compression can be daunting, but I hope I've inspired you to give it a go. Make those drums a lot more punchier and your basses beefier. Please slam the subscribe button. There's some links in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Keep on listening to your heart.